So do you feel that you're being overstimulated? You just don't know what's going on. Things look really bright. There's noise everywhere. And you just feel that maybe you just can't cope at that particular point. So what I'm going to do today is look about sensory overload, the common symptoms that you can experience, how the perimenopause and menopause can impact on this, and what you can do to help yourself. So what is sensory overload? This occurs when one or more of your body's senses or sensory organs becomes overexposed to stimulation. You can feel overwhelmed. It can be very, very stressful. You find that at that particular moment, you can't cope. So this is to do with things like sight, what you're seeing, sounds, what you're hearing, what you're touching, what you're tasting, and what you're smelling. So it could be things like, for instance, you're at work, you're finding it really hard to concentrate on what you're doing. Everybody's yapping and talking behind you. The radio's going, the lights are on, your computer lights are glaring in your eyes. And suddenly you just think, I can't cope with this. I need to get out of here. It could be you're in the supermarket queue, so it's really busy. It's probably too hot. People are bumping into you. It's talking everywhere. There's supermarket music in the background. All you're doing is trying to load your shopping onto the conveyor belt. And just suddenly there's a sense of panic. You feel you're being rushed and that people behind you are trying to push you through. Could be you're at home. You've had a busy day at work, so you get home, so the TV's on, so there's noise blaring. Maybe you've got teenage kids upstairs and their music or games are going on, so there's noise everywhere. You're trying to cook dinner, the dog's barking, the telephone's going, people are trying to talk to you and through each ear. And again, you just find, this is it. I need to shut myself away somewhere. So this is all to do with our senses being heightened and triggered much more easily. It can, and the symptoms could be that suddenly everything's too bright. As I mentioned before, it could be that noise is really bothering you now. You can't cope with everyday sounds. It could be smells. There's certain things that maybe you don't like your perfume anymore, or you find that certain foods now just make you kind of feel sick. It may well be that you can't cope with certain fabrics on your skin. It may be that you're feeling really irritated, you're frustrated, you're very easily annoyed. You find that all these kind of stimulatory things are just getting on top of you. Whereas before you could basically shut your ears or just, you know, close your eyes for a minute or two and everything would be okay. It can be increased panic and anxiety. So it could be panic attacks just that can come out in the middle of nowhere. You might find that as I mentioned before, in the supermarket, it may be you have to travel to work on the bus or the train and just the crowd suddenly become overbearing and you feel that you need to escape. And in this situation, you might really panic. You might get really tense and you might find you're getting palpitations and breathlessness as well. So why on earth does this happen? Especially if you were a good coper with all sorts of things beforehand. So we know that estrogen plays quite an important part in the neurological regulation in brain chemicals such as serotonin and dopamine. Now, serotonin and dopamine, they help to enhance our mood. They help with cognitive function. They help with sensory perceptions. So if your estrogen starts to fall, then that can alter the way that your brain perceives these sensory inputs. So you reach a threshold much quicker than you would have done normally, and stimuli will start these panic attacks and things going at a much earlier stage than they would have done in the past. It can be sleep. You know, the number of you that tell me that you're having problems sleeping, This is a really big issue, because if you are tired, if you are fatigued, your brain function is going to be a lot slower and a lot more difficult to focus to start with, you know. And if you are tired, especially if you've had nights and nights of bad sleep, then just day-to-day living, never mind all these extra sensory stimuli, can be completely overwhelming. It can be mood and anxiety. We know that a lot of you can experience anxiety, low mood, mood swings, and depression. So again, in these circumstances, your threshold for being able to cope with these extra sensory perceptions will be much lower as well. It can be neurological changes. So there seems to be some research coming out about the menopause. It's the fact that the changing hormones can be linked to changes in the way the brain functions, and also the brain structure as well. So it's possible that these actual physical changes to the brain can affect the way that we perceive external things as well. So what can you do to help yourself? So you're looking at stress management. That is so important. If you're getting panic attacks all the time, then you want to be able to, at least when you realize you're in a situation that is possibly going to trigger this. So it's the deep breathing. Go onto YouTube, find these little quick exercises, get into the habit of doing them every day. And then when something does happen, you can jump straight into the breathing. And it's amazing how quickly slow, deep breathing can change the way you feel and can reduce things like panic attacks. You've got things like yoga, you've got meditation, you've got mindfulness. All of these can help to calm an overexcited nervous system down. You can also improve your sleep, really important, although I know this is a really difficult one for a lot of you, but any improvement in sleep is going to have a positive impact on your moods the following day. Good diet, really important here. Your brain uses up heaps of nutrients for it in order to function well. So with all these physical changes going on, your nutritional needs go up. So really make sure that you're getting a good varied diet, and remember to stay hydrated. Dehydration will shrink the brain, it will affect your cognitive functioning, and it will also trigger anxiety and panic attacks. So water, really, really important here. You can also look at creating a safe and calming place in your house if you can. So especially if you've still got family, if you're in a busy household, try and see if there can be somewhere where you can shut yourself away. Just maybe for half an hour when you come in from work, or if things get a bit too much. So very often the bedroom's a nice place. Keep it decluttered, have really soft lighting, kind of neutral colours, and just somewhere where you can go and close your eyes and just have you all to yourself for a little bit of time before you have to go and do whatever else that you need to do. Limit stimulatory foods and drinks. So that's your caffeine. This is possibly one of the worst things that you can have. A really good tip here: don't have coffee the minute you get up in the morning, because that's going to overload your system before you've even started your day. Have a big glass of warm water, have your breakfast, then have your coffee, and it will have much less of an impact on absolutely everything. For looking after your nervous system, really important. The stronger and more robust it is, the more it will be able to cope with everything that's going on. You can look towards our menopause support. This contains magnesium, and we know that magnesium supports the nervous system and helps to fight fatigue as well. You can look at herbs such as passion flower and lemon balm. Passion flower is known to help with relaxation, and we have it in a handy spray that you can carry around with you whenever you need it. Also, with your family, because they're maybe not understanding why you want to shut yourself away and why you're getting so irritable and maybe getting panic attacks and just wanting to scream or walk out the door. So let them know what's going on, because that way they can help you rather than maybe be a little bit antagonistic. At some point, if you've tried all these tips, if you find that nothing is helping, if things are getting worse, if this kind of sensory overload is affecting your quality of daily life, if it's affecting your work, if it's affecting your family, please do speak to your doctor. It may be that you just need a little bit of extra help to help you through this particular phase, and there's certainly nothing wrong with that. So if you have experienced this, how did you get on? What did you do to help yourself? Please share your stories. You know I love to read them. Any of you have got any great tips, then please share them, because somebody out there will benefit from what you've experienced as well. Have a lovely week, and I will see you soon.